Hi everyone. Thought instead of putting a posting on Google Classroom or sending an email remind, I'd post a little video just to kind of go over a few things as to what's going to be happening here in the next few days and weeks ahead. Right now, things are still the same. As I'm speaking to you, there hasn't been any change. So the plan is that we're going to be doing our remote learning through FID today and next week, and hopefully be able to return to school. The one assignment that you have going on for right now would be your midterm exam review packet, which you received quite a few days ago, and do have some copies online through Google Classroom that you can take a look at. I shared a Google Doc with you. You can certainly type your answers in that Google Doc. If you already have your original with you that you started to do your handwritten answers to, you can just take pictures of that document and attach the pictures of the handwritten review packet into Google Classroom. So the same place where there is the assignment for you can attach your own assignment, your own pictures, and so that I can still give you the credit for that. So by the end of today, would like you to complete the midterm review packet. Some of you have reached out to me that you completed your midterm review packet and it's at school. If that's the case, then certainly, I don't need you to do it again. Just know that when we return, I'd have to see a copy of that handwritten document, at that point, pretty much immediately, since it's already been completed. So whether you handwrite it or you do it via Google Doc, I don't have a preference between the two. But that's going to be a 25-point assignment that would be going into PowerSchool. So please make sure you do complete that midterm review packet. If you got any questions, by all means, come and contact me via Remind email or something of that sort. Since we're doing a midterm review packet, the question then becomes, well, what about our midterm review exam? And honestly, right now it's a wait and see approach. So if we are returning to school at the end of the month, we'll take that first day and go over the midterm review packet, and then we just be move on to our exam, which is set up to be a 2-day exam, a part one, part two. So we'll kind of reevaluate maybe next week what's going on as we get a little bit more clarity, whether we're going to be returning to school or if this is going to be a little bit long term. I'll give advance notice for the exam, so certainly it wouldn't be something that would just show up on a random Wednesday or the first day that we come back to school. The way the exam is set up now is over 2 days, part one, part two, and it's strictly short answer. So everything is written. It's not a Scantron. It's not essay question by any means, but it's one where you have to be able to identify, logical fallacies or eloquence, not just by definition, but by example. So if it's material that's on the review packet, it's material that you're going to be responsible for. So I could have some excerpts from a speech, and you'd have to identify what types of eloquence are being used. Could have an example of a logical fallacy, and you'd have to identify what type of logical fallacy is being utilized. There is a potential, and certainly it's a potential, that this could switch to a multiple choice type format, and that would be if I'm administering the midterm, via Google Forms with remote learning here through Google Classroom, might switch it to a multiple choice as opposed to a short answer. But I just can't give any definitives with that yet. So as things become a little bit clearer for us, I'll certainly let you know what the format of that exam would look like ahead of time, so you have an idea as to what to prepare. But basically, if it's content that's on the midterm review packet, it would be expected that that's material that you're knowledgeable about and comfortable with. And I would expect, anything from the midterm review packet to be assigned for either part one or part two. So part one will have some logical fallacies, assuming we go with the short answer setup. Part one will have some logical fallacy and eloquence questions. Part two, I would anticipate also to have some logical fallacy and eloquence questions. So just because one aspect of the course of the content gets covered in day one of the test doesn't mean that that same type of content can't show up in part two. So certainly be prepared for that. What is definitely coming next also for us, assignment-wise, is going to be Student Congress. And the idea with Student Congress, and today you're going to be watching, kind of taking notes, a video that's going to introduce the whole assignment to you, the project. You're going to be introducing a bill, and you're going to be defending that bill. So it's essentially boils down to two things: you introducing something into law, a new law, or you would be taking a law away, retracting a law that is in current form and basically nullifying it. So you'll receive notes, another video here for you to look at, and materials that I have under for FID Day for today, which is FID Day number three. But that intro note video will kind of explain what's going on with the project. It'll be a little bit longer than what this one is. You will have a parliamentary procedure quiz then next Thursday, and a research planner due next Thursday, and these will both be via Google Classroom. And as I said, I'll outline that in the next video. There is a potential possibility, depending how long that we are not in school, that we're doing remote learning, that when you do student congress, you're not debating against anyone. You're just really advocating for a bill, for a law to go into effect. So there is a possibility, depending how long we'll be out of school, that you might have to record and submit your bill speeches. That's something where the details I still have to work out. But it's kind of planning for the possibility that, you know, it might be a little while before we have face-to-face interaction in person, and so you might have to do some recording of that speech. But we'll certainly get into those specifics. The speeches themselves would still be at least a couple weeks away. Not only do you have time to do some research, but there's also some other assignments that kind of lead up into it, which we'll take care of. Speaking of speeches, we still have a couple eloquence resolutions that we did not get to debate yet. And so currently, those are just simply kind of on hold. Right now, I'm not going to have people do a digital speech debate. Certainly not going to force people to get together here in our age of social distancing and perform a speech and submit it. So right now, if you did not complete your eloquent speech, it's basically just on hold. It's certainly not missing. It's not a zero in or anything like that. But that's just going to currently be on hold for now. Those of you who did complete your eloquent speeches, I did put those scores into PowerSchool along with the article analysis. And then also this weekend, I should be able to put in your midterm review packet points as well. So those points in PowerSchool will certainly continue to be updated. If you have any questions about anything, you know, pertaining with course work, you know, certainly you can shoot me an email. Two email addresses, the nhsd.net or the staff Gmail. I think the staff Gmail is probably the better of the two. Just works a little bit better going Gmail to Gmail than worrying about the spam filter. But there's also the Remind app. And I did on Google Classroom put a discussion thread just within the FID material. So if you have any questions about something, and it looks like we already got a question viewed that I'll take a look at. But if you have a question about something or you come across anything that would be useful for resource material, feel free to post it on there and we'll take a look and try to get back to you with that. But otherwise, I hope everyone's doing well. I know it's a little bit of uncharted territory that we're in. Stay healthy, stay safe, and look forward to seeing everyone hopefully soon. All right, take care.